Now, if you do this one thing here, you will never master the golf swing. This is such a common fault we see with so many amateur golfers, and it is the main reason why a lot of you struggle so much with consistency. So let's fix it, and then you can have that good golf swing, and maybe you master it. So I'm JChown from channel JChownGolf. Let's dive right into it. So you're probably thinking, well, what is this thing that I'm doing, which is the reason why I'm bad at golf? And that is, you are shifting far too much onto your trail leg in the backswing. You're loading and laterally shifting way too much. So why is that bad? Because you've probably, a lot of you have had that told to you in lessons that you've got to do it. You've got to load into that weight shift. You've got to shift your weight back. You've got to shift your weight through. You can see right there why that's bad. How much movement did I have to do going back and then forward again? How fast is a golf swing? Even for the slower guys out there, pretty fast. Are you going to be able to do that in that space of time? No, you're not. You're not. So if you're going back this much, we have to move even more in a downswing, because we know we've got to shift our weight in the downswing. We've got to get ourselves to where we are more towards that target than where we were at setup, because we've got to shift to control our low point and get our lowest point in front of the golf ball. So for irons, of course. If we've then got more room we have to travel, more space to travel to be able to do that, by nature, that is not going to be as consistent. So we've got to do this better. We've got to figure out a better way to turn in the backswing, so our low point from our shifting can be controlled with a smaller amount of movement, because that will be more consistent. Let's find out how to do it. So how we do this? Two words: pressure, shift. So this is backswing, pressure, shift. So how do we do this? We are shifting our pressure into our trail leg, not our weight. So if we shift our weight into that trail leg, we're shifting the whole weight of our body. If we're shifting our pressure, we're keeping ourselves centered as we turn, but we're still technically getting the weight into this right leg, but our pressure is going into our trail heel as we turn up. That's going to keep us right on top of the golf ball. We're now not off away from it. So now we have less movement we have to do to get in front of the golf ball with our legs and our upper body. More consistent. So you're going to get that low point going in there. So pressure shift. This pressure goes into our trail heel as we turn back, creating this. So let's hit one here, and we're going to talk about a really good drill which is going to fix this problem, and it's going to teach you the difference between both of these, pressure and weight shift as well. Really, really good drill. But let's hit a shot, see how I do. Felt pretty good because I shifted pressure, not weight. Let's get into the drill. So, good old camping chair. If you watch a lot of my videos, you must think, wow, he goes out camping a lot to always have this chair in his videos. I never go out camping ever. Just have it. So what we need to do here, this is going to teach us how to shift our pressure and not our weight. We don't need to get all our weight onto that trail side. We just need our pressure going there, keep us centered. So if I put the chair here and I put it really about a ball's distance outside my trail leg here. Now, I can turn here in a backswing, get a full good turn, stay centered, and never hit this. In fact, I can actually get my weight into my trail leg, get out to the top of my backswing, and create more space than I've got right now at the top of my backswing between my trail leg and the chair. Watch this. So I'm gonna get to the top and stop. So that nice kind of ball distance here. Look at the amount of gap that's here now. Look at the amount of gap that's there now. So one thing to notice as well, if you can see my lead foot, the heel's off the ground. That's more something I do. You can do that as well. I'll put a card at the end of the video for a video on that. But you can see there's more gap here. But I've still got the weight in this trail foot. So you might be thinking, well, he's doing stack and tilt, isn't he? Staying on that left side. I'm not stack and tilting. I'm getting my pressure going into my trail heel. It's all in my heel. If I had a pressure pad down right now, you'd see a lot of it in my pretty much 90%, maybe a little bit more, in that right foot. but a massive gap's been formed. It's because I am turning my hips, I am shifting my pressure, not my weight. Now I've got so much less movement to really get myself laterally shifting and hit ball than turf. You can see I'm going to hit a ball here. Remember, little ball's distance. Let's hit a shot. Oh, that was struck really good. Look at that there. Look at the amount of space there was. And I still had my weight in this trail side. So that's almost an exercise in itself there. See if you can get a chair, put it up just about. You can either have a hands or a ball's distance away from your trail leg. And I want you to turn, create a gap, but still feel the pressure going into your right heel. What are you going to notice? You're going to have to turn your hips to do it. So that's going to help you with power as well. So that's going to definitely make you master the golf swing, hit the ball further, but it's going to keep you centered, like we said. Good exercise there. Just turn back, stop, turn back, stop, create that gap, get that pressure into that trail heel. That's our way we got to go, because if you start to shift weight, straight away, you're going to be side hipping this chair further and further away from you. Instant feedback. A lot of you don't practice with feedback, which is mind-blowing. You've got to practice with feedback, because how else are you going to know whether you've done it right or wrong unless you're filming every swing? As well, do that, please. Do this and film your swing. If you're not doing any of them, it's going to be very hard for you to know whether you're actually making a change in your golf swing. So you have to know through feedback one way or the other. Have to do it. So, ball flight alone, guys, you can see somewhat, but even coaches now, we all have video. We video pretty much every swing. We go off a little bit off ball flight, but if our coaches only go off a little bit off ball flight, amateur golfers will not be able to know a thing going off ball flight. So film your swing, have a feedback drill. So have this here. Now, when I've got set up to this, it's not here. If I'm here to a golf ball right here, it's not right in front of me. It's at to a point where I'm not going to hit it in my downswing. So make sure you're at it with a point where it's not going to affect the path of your golf club in the downswing. This drill will be awesome. Once you've done the feel with it with some practice swings, that good hands distance, hit a shot. There we go. You're going to be hitting ball than turf pretty much every single time. You're going to be playing way better golf. So do that drill. Don't shift your weight, shift your pressure. This will teach you to do it and you'll be playing way better golf. You'll be way closer to becoming a really good golfer, maybe even mastering the swing. So if you enjoyed this video, click that like button. If you want more golf instruction just like this, hit a subscribe button and hit the bell button too to be notified every time I put out a video. So, shift the pressure, know your weight, you'll be better.